me on New Year's. 3, 2, 1, Happy New Year! Anyone want to kiss me? No? Louie? No? Alright. Hey guys, what's up? Today's video is all about New Year's Eve. As you can tell, it's in a few days. It's very close, so I'm super pumped for this video. I thought it would be fun to show you guys some last minute outfit ideas along with a makeup idea and also a DIY photo booth kind of thing. I hope you guys enjoy it. Let me know in the comments what your New Year's resolution is. I think mine is going to be to drink less dairy. I know it's like a thing and like a joke that I really like milk. I stayed up till 3 a.m. one night just watching scary videos about the dairy industry and like meat, and now I'm just kind of like scarred. Let me know what yours is down below. Make sure you guys are subscribed to this channel if you're new so you can get pumped for all my videos in the new year, and also follow me on social media so that you can hang out with me and see what I'm doing when I'm not posting videos. I think that's it. Let's get into it.
First off, hold up. I'm doing a makeup tutorial? What? This never happens. I haven't shown you guys how I actually do my makeup in so long, so that's pretty exciting. Thumbs up if you want more videos like this. Starting off with what to do with your makeup, I thought of this really super easy makeup look that I'll probably be wearing. So I already did my foundation, and then I'm taking my Makeup Forever concealer and just putting that on any blemishes I want to cover up. Then I'm taking this Maybelline concealer to highlight my face, just on my chin, nose, forehead, under my eyes, to make me look not tired, because you gotta stay up late on New Year's Eve. And then blending that in with a beauty blender as well. That thing is my life. I'm obsessed with it. If you don't use one, you're missing out. Next, I'm taking this Laura Mercier loose powder, and I'm just dipping my brush in there and just putting it under my eyes to set it all and just avoid creasing under there. And then I'm taking my Laura Mercier pressed powder and setting the rest of my face with that. Next is brows, and I'm using this Anastasia brow pencil, whiz, whatever it's called, thingy-majig, and just filling in my brows. It's my fave thing to do, brushing them out. It probably takes me a solid 10 minutes just to do my eyebrows. Like, I'm not kidding. That's really sad, but they're just my fave. Then I'm using a brow gel to set them in place and have them not move throughout the day and get all crazy. As for your eyeshadow, I'm using my Tarte Tartlet palette. It's just a very neutral palette, and it's my freaking obsession. I'm taking this matte light brown and putting that all over my lid just as like a kind of base. Then I'm taking this shimmery kind of brown color, I think it's brownish, silverish, and putting that on my lid. And then I'm taking the darkest color that's almost black but kind of brown and putting that on the outer corner V area. And then I'm highlighting with this matte cream white-ish color on my brow bones and the inner corner. I love it. Then I'm taking all of those dark colors and putting them under my eye as well. Then I'm going in with a liquid eyeliner. This is one from Kat Von D. It's the best and easiest thing to use ever, so I'm obsessed with it. So I just did the winged eyeliner, and I'm also going to be applying fake eyelashes for this because I just really like them lately. I'm all about my lash game being as strong as possible, so gonna go do that. And then I'm applying a coat of mascara just to blend that all together. And back to the face, I'm of course doing some contouring, and I'm taking this middle-ish brown color. This is from the Anastasia contour palette, I'm pretty sure that's what it is. Yeah, I think so. So I'm just going to contour my cheekbones, forehead, my nose, because that's a thing apparently. I don't know. I try, guys. And then just like under my jawbone and my neck. And yeah, then I'm going in with this very neutral blush color. And then my favorite part, highlighting. This is Champagne Pop from Becca, and it's the best thing ever. And I'm just putting that on my cheekbones. And last but not least, the lips, my favorite part. I'm first lining them with this lip pencil from MAC. I think it's in the color Whirl. And then I'm taking this Buxom lip pencil lipstick thing in the color Sydney and just putting that all over. And it's really pretty and nice. And that's it for the makeup. Before I show show you guys some awesome outfit ideas, I thought I would just show you the super easy, simple way you can have fun at a party and just take some awesome Instagram photos. And that is to make a photo booth. Head to the party store and grab a bunch of stuff, like those little streamers for the wall, like 2016 balloons, and then just a bunch of really fun, cool props. And it's just super fun and a cool way to add decor to your party if you're having one. If you're not, you could still make one and it'll look like you had a party. Me on New Year's. For the first outfit idea, I'm wearing this high-necked black crop top with little crystal-y snowflake looking things on it. And then my fringe black skirt from H&M, it was super cheap. And these glittery tights, which I'm obsessed with, they're so cool. And these blue booties. By the way, totally leave me in the comments which outfit out of all of these I should wear on actual New Year's, because I need to decide still and I definitely want to wear one of them. But this next one is really, really cute. I got this like sequined romper thing from Forever 21. And then my furry black cardigan is from Brandy Melville. And I'm just pairing it with some chokers from Topshop and some black sheer tights and some black booties. The next outfit is super chic. This faux fur jacket is from Topshop. Wow, actually everything that I'm wearing literally is from Topshop except for these shoes. These shoes are from Steve Madden, but as for everything else, Topshop. They have awesome New Year's stuff right now, just so you guys know. But I'm obsessed with this like velvet blue romper with the high neck. I just think it's so cute. And this last outfit is very simple and easy. It's just a jumpsuit, so it's literally just one item of clothing. It's from Topshop, if you're wondering, but they have similar stuff at Forever 21. And I just paired it with these black heels. And I just think the fact that it's long makes it extra fancy and nice looking. So if you have a bit more of a fancy party to go to, I would definitely recommend a long dress or something like this.
I feel like Alicia right now. Did you like it? Did you like it? Did you like it? Anyway. Make sure to like the video if you enjoyed it. Leave me a comment. Follow me. I think that's it. I hope you guys have an awesome rest of the year. And I will see you next year. Love you guys. Bye. Since I left the city.